It's a beautiful morning.
First time I ever saw Michael, I was at WBRZ for my job interview. I remember I looked down that hallway with all the editing bays, and there he was. He had a purple shirt on, his hair was a little longer, a little fluffier, and khaki pants, purple shirt. I just thought he was the cutest.
When she first walked through the newsroom in August of 2012, I remember thinking at the time, just keep working. There's no need to look up. Just keep doing what you're doing.
We went New Year's 2013. We went to L'Auberge. And that was the night where he didn't kiss me at midnight, and I was really upset about it. And he said to me, he said, I really wanted to kiss you at midnight. And I said, well, why didn't you? It's a perfect opportunity. So then he kissed me then at the bar. And then the next day we went to Fat Cow. That's my favorite burger in town.
Our first date was at the burger place on Highland Road. I want to say the name of it escapes me, Fat Cow. Fat Cow was our first date. Burger place on Highland Road on January 1st, 2013, around 1 o'clock in the afternoon. She got the burger. In the middle of the night, I go walking in my sleep.
From the mountains of fame, to the river so deep. Baton Rouge Country Club, par 3, hole 12.
The Baton Rouge Country Club on number 12. So the story behind that is I, of course, was incredibly nervous, and it was a terrible day. Cold, wet, carts on path. I hate carts on path. And it was kind of raining before we teed off, but I was dead set on doing it that weekend because we were going out of town. I want to say the next weekend we're going to Scottsdale. I wanted to be engaged before that because I didn't want Scottsdale to be the place where we got engaged. And I wanted it to be special to Baton Rouge because this is where we're gonna make our home, raise our family. So we teed off on number 10, and I had planned to do it in the back corner of the course, which is number 12, kind of secluded. So the plan was always to wait for Brittany to make some sort of miraculous putt or a great chip shot or something. And sure enough, on number 10, she's behind the green, and the green, two-tiered green, slopes this way. And of course, she chips in for par on number 10. And I thought, well, shit, I just lost my opportunity. But then two holes later, on number 12, she's in the trap left. I'm short of the green and right. So I pitched up there, two-putted for bogey. And Brittany pitches hers out of the trap to the top right side of the green. And sure enough, she's got like 30 feet for par and just rolls it in. Never a doubt, rolls it in. I said, all right, here we go. She said, I love you, I'm shaking. And her hands were shaking. And then we looked around and there was some guy standing in his front yard watching.
This ain't no disco. It ain't no country club either. All I
wanna do is have a little fun. No, he really kills that thing off the tee.
Absolutely. Without a doubt. She hits everything just dead straight.
I can read that kid like a book. Let me just tell you that. It's very obvious. I know right away when he's upset because he'll make this face, you know, sometimes he'll, I just know. I just know. Sometimes he'll bite his finger and go like this. He doesn't like when I do my eyebrow roll thing.
How do you do that?
This thing. He said it weirds him out. He also doesn't like when I put all my belongings on the ironing board, because that's his space.
Well, there's different stages of how she says my name. If it's just Michael, that's, she's just kind of annoyed with whatever I've done. Or if it's Michael, then I know that it's getting more serious. If it's Michael, I know I'm in big trouble. I don't make the bed every morning. Getting better at that. My flagellance.
Oh, look at her. He tells me that. He gives me a kiss before he leaves every day, or before I leave, I'll give him a kiss. Big smooch.
Every night when I come home, we live in a one-bedroom studio right now, so the goal is to be as quiet as you can when the other is sleeping. So I'll come in, and I've gotten pretty good at just slowly turning the key. I know exactly how far to open the door to make the door not make a noise. I hang the key up and hold the entire keychain like this and hang it up to where it doesn't make any noise, and go in, change clothes, and then by the time I get in bed, that's when it wakes her up and I give her a kiss on her forehead, and then she hates when I kiss her nose, so I kiss her nose.
He has a lot of holy shirts, like shirts with holes in them. I always ask him why he holds on to them. I think they probably have sentimental value.
All the things she hasn't worn in 6 years. I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric. I'd probably just leave it up to Brittany, because she's going to pick anyway.
Well, because we're going to get a Great Dane, a black and white Great Dane, and then we're probably going to get a little Yorkie too. So it'll probably be like, I don't know, Marmaduke will be the small dog's name. And then, you know, Tiny will probably be the the Great Dane. Snuggling. We have a lot of snuggle time.
Just relax and be silly. And, you know, we have such stressful lives that it's pretty awesome to come home and just not dwell on any of that and just act like kids. Lay on the couch, watch movies, binge watch Netflix shows, play golf. I mean, that's a kind of a loaded question. There's so many things we do together. For once in my life,
I have someone who needs me. He doesn't really have a ton of bad habits. He cleans up after himself. I mean, let me see. He puts the toilet seat down. He gets an A+ a lot.
That's not her habit. That's my habit. her worst habit. I'll ask her if she flossed today. She always says yes, but I know the answer is no. Let sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. I do. I don't even get what I did mean.
I do.
Thanks for watching.
We'll be right back after this.
Good afternoon. Welcome to KCHS News. I'm Matt Miller.
And I'm Michael Shingleton. Here are our stories for the day.
Good afternoon. I'm Brittany Weiss with today's topic of inventions.
Good afternoon. I'm Brittany Weiss.
And I'm Michael Shingleton. Thanks for joining us for News 2 at 4 o'clock.
Can we have one with the bridesmaid? Lovely. Now, anyone who's wearing a suit for the first time. Super. Now, drunk uncles, all drunken uncles. Now, everyone who is invited out of politeness, but wasn't expected to turn up. Okay. Super. Now, anyone who slept with the bride? Vicar? Yes, Vicar? I need the timer for this one. Go. Now, anyone who slept with the groom? And anyone who thinks this will last?